This week we cover Isar Aerospace, a German company that builds orbital rockets designed to transport small and medium-sized satellites into space. As one of the emerging commercial launch providers in Germany, Isar Aerospace aims to provide a fully privately funded European option for accessing space. They see themselves as a disruptor in the space industry. Founded in 2018, they are working to open up space by providing a highly competitive launch service, offering payloads of up to 1,000 kilos, that's approximately 2,200 pounds, to orbit. Next, let's take a look at the technology they use to create launch vehicles. Isar Aerospace makes full use of the latest technologies such as additive manufacturing. That's a fancy phrase for 3D printers. The primary structure of the vehicle uses lightweight carbon composite structures. In addition, Isar uses a great deal of automation in the manufacturing process, allowing for increased precision and efficiency in machining and welding. This process enables Isar Aerospace to accelerate production while maintaining the highest level of accuracy in their manufacturing processes. Spectrum, a two-stage launch vehicle. The Spectrum launch vehicle is powered by a cluster of 9 Aquila engines on the first stage and 1 vacuum-optimized Aquila engine on the second stage. The Aquila engine is a high-performance liquid-fueled engine developed in-house by Isar Aerospace. It has undergone extensive testing, including 124 hot fire tests, demonstrating its reliability and performance. The Aquila engine is designed to provide the necessary thrust for the Spectrum launch vehicle to carry payloads of up to 1,000 kilos to low Earth orbit and up to 700 kilos, that's approximately 1,500 pounds, to Sun's synchronous orbit. The vehicle is 28 meters tall, that's 92 feet, with a diameter of 2 meters, or 6.5 feet. What about the engines that power this vehicle? Aquila is the name of Spectrum's engines. They are fully in-house designed and manufactured like the rest of the vehicle. They use high-pressure turbopump-fed engines. The first stage's 9 Aquila engines provide the initial thrust needed to lift the vehicle off the ground and accelerate towards space. The second stage's single Aquila engine is optimized for operation in the vacuum of space and features a multi-ignition capability, allowing it to be shut down and reignited as needed to accommodate various mission profiles and orbital requirements. This multi-ignition capability provides Isar Aerospace's customers with increased flexibility in payload deployment and mission planning, making the Spectrum launch vehicle a versatile and adaptable solution for a wide range of small and medium-sized satellite missions. Next, let's check out the propulsion for the Spectrum vehicle. The Spectrum launch vehicle is powered by liquid oxygen and propane, offering high-performing, clean propulsion that minimizes the environmental impact. These propellants offer the highest density specific impulse of all carbon-based fuels, resulting in higher payload capacity than many other European commercial launch providers such as High Impulse, Skyroarer, or Orbex. If you're not familiar with those other companies, no worries, I'll be covering them in future videos. As a result of this high-performing, clean propulsion system, Isar Aerospace is able to offer one of the highest payload capacities amongst European commercial launch providers. Only Rocket Factory Augsburg has a higher stated payload capacity as of now. While the quoted payload figures are promising, it's important to note that these new commercial space startups have not yet launched, so the actual performance of their vehicle remains to be seen. Next, let's look at where they will be launching from. This can be an important factor for potential customers and also affects types of orbits that are achievable. Isar Aerospace has an exclusive launch pad in Andøya, Norway. Given its location far north on the coastline, Andøya offers launch inclinations ranging from 87.4 to 108 degrees. These are favorable for sun synchronous as well as polar orbits. Andøya Space started out providing suborbital launch facilities all the way back in 1962. Over 1,200 sounding rockets and suborbital research rockets have flown from this base. It is now branching out to providing facilities suitable for orbital launch vehicles. Europe can literally not launch a single satellite on its own, Daniel Metzler, Isar's CEO, said in an interview. The lack of launch infrastructure is a core bottleneck in the region and means Europe has to turn to the US for help, he said. According to Metzler, Isar is seeking to launch up to 15 missions per year for Andøya, at a cost of 10 to 12 million euros. That's about 10.7 to 12.8 million US dollars. Next up, what has Isar achieved so far? Let's check out the main milestones since it was founded in 2018. In April 2021, Isar signs an agreement with Airbus Defence and Space. The agreement sees Airbus Defence and Space commit to one launch, with options for additional launches, of a small Earth observation satellite using the Spectrum launch vehicle. This is the first major launch contract Isar has won with an established space company. In October 2021, Endurosat signs a launch contract with Isar. Endurosat has signed an agreement with Isar to launch its satellites on rideshare missions between 2022 and 2025. Financial terms and the number of launches were not disclosed. In December 2021, Astrocast taps Isar for upcoming launches. Astrocast is a provider of nanosatellites, announced an agreement with Isar. In 2024, Isar will launch a rideshare mission to a sun-synchronous orbit from the Andøya spaceport. In December 2021, payloads financed by the German Space Agency selected for the first flight of Spectrum. The German Space Agency, DLR, has paid for and selected payloads for Isar Aerospace's first launch. In fact, DLR selected payloads from five institutions through a micro-launcher competition. The payloads are from Germany, Norway, and Slovenia. A total of seven small satellites will be launched with a total weight of about 100 kilos, that's about 220 pounds. They will be deployed into a polar orbit from the Norwegian spaceport of Andøya. In July 2022, Isar is selected to be the first space startup company to launch from French Guiana, that's ESA's main spaceport. This is the second spaceport Isar has secured. They previously secured access to Andøya in Norway for polar and SSO orbits. The spaceport in French Guiana is located close to the equator and is ideal for a wide range of orbits. The spin of the Earth at the equator gives an extra boost to rockets, leading to lower launch costs or a higher payload. Isar will be able to launch vehicles from this spaceport from 2024. In January 2023, Isar signs a rideshare deal with Spaceflight. Isar gets its first American customer with a signing for a multi-launch agreement with Spaceflight. Spaceflight Inc. acts as a launch broker and payload integrator. They act as a go-between between the customer and the launch provider. This simplifies the process and takes care of finding suitable launchers and dealing with payload integration and other matters. Metzler's thoughts on European access to space. Speaking as a European, it's terribly sad to see that Europe literally does not have any launch capability right now, he said. It's a huge impact where not only governments and agencies, space agencies and defence agencies are dependent on non-European technology. It puts the fate of European future in space into non-European hands. You have to already have the right designs in order to get to a point where you can do a significant double-digit number of launches even for a single customer, Metzler said. If a customer wants to buy 20 flights a year, you don't want to sell your entire launch manifest to one customer. In that case, you would have to build 50 to 60 plus rockets a year. We just take a significantly different approach to anyone else by automating the manufacturing around it. Europe, as of today, is very much in a place where the US was about 15 years ago, still stuck with established players and doing business because we did it the last 40 years in the same way. It is only on the brink of thinking about new ways to open up the industry. And finally, in milestones for Isar Aerospace, in March 2023, Isar Aerospace raised $165 million in funding. Isar Aerospace completed a funding round worth $165 million to help it scale up production of its Spectrum launch vehicle. In total, Isar has raised $330 million to date. Executives at Isar said they have enough funding to get to the first launch with margin in the event of a launch failure. This is important because of how common it is for new vehicles to experience problems on the maiden flight and early in their flight history. Thanks for watching. We plan to cover more German launch providers such as High Impulse and Rocket Factory Augsburg in future videos. Please like and subscribe to see more videos on the new commercial launcher startup scene. We keep you covered with all the news on the planet, in orbit, and the moon and beyond. See you soon.